Hey there, when it comes to Home Assistant automation configuration files, are you a little confused about whether you should use a text editor or whether you should use the GUI editor, Graphical User Interface? Well, in this episode, I'm going to give you a bit of advice on how to decide which you should use at which time. And I'm going to go through a few differences between the two. And make sure you stick around to the end, because I'll be showing you a few tips on how to make your life when it comes to YAML configuration files a little easier. All that in this episode. First of all, if you're new here, then my name is John, and here at Hascasts, I cover all things Home Assistant and home automation in general. That's tips, tricks, and tutorials, just like this one. So if you are new here and you fancy subscribing at any time, then please feel free. I would love to have you join me on this fairly new journey and join our wonderful community. Right, so let's jump into the video. Right, so if you did manage to watch the first video, and if you recall, I said that there were two ways to create Home Assistant automation files. The first one being by using the GUI, which is the graphical user interface that Home Assistant provides for us. And that's there to make our Home Assistant automation life a little easier, especially for beginners. And the second way is to lovingly handcraft your .yaml automation files. Now, this gives us more control, but it is a little harder. So which should you use? Well, let's look at that. So if you're going to create a nice, simple automation, such as I want light A to turn on when I enter the room. Well, in that case, it's easy enough just to use the GUI. That's what it's designed for. It's nice and easy, and it can handle it. However, if either you prefer using a code editor, an IDE, or if it's something that the GUI cannot handle or cannot do, then in that case, you obviously should use the code editor. So if you want to use the GUI, then the first thing that you should do really is go into it, take a look, and have a look at the options, see what options it gives you. And from there, you will have a better idea on whether you will actually be able to use the GUI for your automation. A very simplified example is light.turnOn. If it doesn't give you that option, then you obviously can't use the GUI for that. So what happens if you can't use the GUI for your automation? Well, in that case, you obviously need a code editor. Where are you going to get a code editor from? Well, it depends on what your coding experience is. For example, if you're using Microsoft Windows, I said this in episode one, if you're using Microsoft Windows and you have little to no coding experience, then you could use something like the Configurator, which is available to install in Home Assistant. And I will link in the corner to a video that I did on Configurator. Or you could use a similar one, which is the IDE add-on, and that is available for has.io. And a few days ago, in fact, Frank updated that, and that now has several more features and it's a lot more stable. However, if you're a little more confident with code, then again, the IDE add-on is fantastic. It gives you color syntax, it gives you a built-in terminal, all sorts of things. It's actually swayed me from my normal IDE that I use. The other alternative, of course, is to download a dedicated IDE that will give you a vast array of options and tools that you can use to work with your code and your configuration files. If you think that you're going to be spending quite a bit of time on configuration files, then it may be worth you looking into that option. Now, because the GUI is quite young and it's in its infancy, relatively speaking, then you've got to bear in mind that there may be some things that it still can't do. Now, that's not the end of the world. Because both the GUI and the code editors have their own advantages and disadvantages. In fact, let's take a look at those advantages and disadvantages. Right, that'll do. Right, so where were we yesterday? The GUI. What are the advantages of using the GUI? Well, it's quite easy to read. There's quite a bit of white space in between each element, and that gives your brain a bit of time to adjust between different elements and let it soak in before it has to process the next one. The GUI is very beginner friendly. It's designed that way. It's designed so that people with very little coding experience or no coding experience can just come in, go through the drop-down menus, things like that, and pull in configuration from the other screen. And that means that it's got a very shallow learning curve. So what about disadvantages? What are the disadvantages of the GUI? It's not very good for long automations. If you have a long, complicated automation, then you'll find that in order to review it, or if you go back to it at any point, you're scrolling quite a bit. Also, it's very hard for beginners to import and export automations from the GUI. In fact, I don't think there is a way to import and export from the GUI. Please correct me in the comments if I'm wrong. But in order to do that, in order to import and export, you have to go into the automations.yaml file and copy and paste the automation that you're after. And considering that there are no gaps in the YAML file, it's all automation, 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 one after another, no comments or anything like that. It's quite hard to import and export for beginners. Let's move on to the editor or the IDE. What are the advantages of, say, using an IDE? Well, it's much more configurable. You can configure everything from the size of the text that you use, the color scheme, the size of the color of certain text elements such as variables and classes and things like that. You can configure the line height, so the line spacing, so how many lines you have on a given screen. It's also good for long or complicated automations. And I say that because for a start, you can fit more on a screen than you can with the GUI. So you've got more in one place to look at. But you can also comment your work, which is another advantage. For a developer, commenting your work, in my opinion, is vital, and it's something that everybody should be doing. Because if you yourself have to come back to your work in 2 weeks, 2 months, 6 months' time, you could be coming in looking at something and thinking, why on earth did I put that in there? That shouldn't belong in there. So you take it out only to find that you put that in there because there's a bug elsewhere in the code that you don't have control over, and that is actually a fix to it. So if you comment your code, then you'll find that you will read it and go, that's right, that's right. That idiot never committed his fix, so this is to fix that. Sorry, that's the cat running in the cat flap, and my shoulder giving way. Right, let's move on. Now, with IDEs and code editors, it's very easy to export your code. Basically, if you want to say ask for help on the Home Assistant community forum, then you can just go into your IDE, copy the text that you're wanting help with, and then paste it over into the forum. It's just a copy and paste job. Or conversely, if you want to have a look at somebody else's code, there are loads of examples on the Home Assistant website of where people have shared their code. And they do that so that you can go in and you can see what they've done. And if you like something that they've done, then you can simply copy their code and paste it into your IDE, into your text editor, make a few modifications to make the entity IDs relevant to your system, And voila, that's it. It now works in your system. As simple as that. And lastly, for the advantages, it's very easy to split up your files. Like I say, with the automations.yaml that the GUI produces, it is just one long file, no matter how many automations you have, because the GUI and the automated side of it doesn't care about splitting them up. It doesn't need to. Whereas for human readability, it's much simpler if you can split up your automations into single files. That makes it much easier to read. It means that if you're working on an automation, then you've just got one file open. That's all you've got to worry about. And whatever is in that file is to do with that automation. Makes it much, much easier to handle. So onto the disadvantages of using the code editor or the GUI. Well, it can sometimes be a bit hard for beginners because you not only have to learn Home Assistant, but you've then got to learn the intricacies of the IDE. It can take ages to set up an IDE the way that you like it. So with the IDEs do have a steeper learning curve, but it is worth it. Also, some people find the choice of editors or IDEs quite confusing. If you're a beginner, then I recommend Notepad++. If you're a moderate user, then again, Notepad++ is quite good because it's got the syntax highlighting. It's free, and if you're an advanced user, then you will obviously have your favorite code editor by now already anyway. So, can you think of any differences that I've missed between GUIs and code editors? Is there something that you've found that I've missed off? Are there any disadvantages or advantages to either that you've found? If there are, then please leave a note in the comments below. You'll recall that at the beginning of this episode, I said that I would share a few tips with you that will make your life when it comes to dealing with YAML configuration files easier. So the first one applies if you're using a code editor or an IDE. So what I want you to do is I want you to go into your preferences or your whatever settings you have and see if you can find a white space option. Right, so if you can find a white space option, then I want you to look a little further into it, and I want you to see if you can see if there's an option to enable showing white space at the beginning of the line. Now, if you can show white space at the beginning of the line, it makes your life dealing with YAML files much, much simpler. Because it means that you can always check that you have the correct level of indentation. Top tip number two is if you have all your automations in a single file, be it automations.yaml or automations old or automation old, whichever one it is, .yaml, then split it up. What you would be better off doing is creating an automations directory under your configuration directory, and then for each automation, just adding a single file under that automations directory. So if you have an automation turn lights off when you go to bed, then create a file called turn lights off when I go to bed .yaml, and just put that one automation into that file. It makes your life much, much easier when you're editing that automation. You just have to have that one file open, and that means that your head isn't confused by the text that's on top of or underneath it. There's nothing else to worry about, and it also means that if you muck it up, then you've only got that one file to worry about. You're not going to accidentally delete your entire automation file. Now, the way that you do that is you put this, yeah, that's right, you put this code into your configurations.yaml file instead of just including the automations.yaml file. And that will make sure that everything in the directory is covered, is imported automatically. Okay, thank you very much. I love you all. Bye-bye.